here? Is it finally here?
Oh. Jatos, is that you?
Yes, it is I.
I've been waiting 4,748 days for this. And finally, the moment has come.
Do you have it?
Finally. All joking aside, this is my friend Protitus. You know him probably as that guy that makes reproduction cards. Well, he came over here with the express intention of teaching me how to make a reproduction card. I wanted to make one for my contest as a prize. Unfortunately, we ran into some problems. You see, I don't have a computer that has that kind of connection, so we can't write chips for the reproduction cards. So instead, I took this man to the swap mart to shop for cheap games to use as donor cards. What is a donor card? I'll let the expert here explain it to you.
A donor card is basically the game we use for a reproduction. It gives its life for a new game that you will enjoy.
Let's elaborate.
You see, not all games are made alike. You can't just use any game to make any card. There are some rules of engagement.
So basically, what we have here is what's called a TK ROM. We pulled this out of a Deja Vu. You can also pull these out of a Shadowgate, an Uninvited, or a Tecmo Basketball. Basically, this is a TS ROM, which would be this board here, pulled out of a Super Mario Bros. 2. And the only difference is that one has the battery and one doesn't. But the boards are basically the same. Now, this is used to make an Earthbound Zero. And if any of you guys have played that, you know, you have to have the battery backup. Now, here's another type of TS ROM. And this also came out of a Super Mario Bros. 2. But the difference is, you see the pins, you have less pins here and more pins there. This was an earlier model. And the way to tell it is, you have your Super Mario Brothers carts and you look underneath the foot. One has the symbol and one doesn't. Now, this one was the one that came out first and it has all the pins. Now, why is this important in reproductions? The reason why is when you make a Final Fantasy III cartridge, you have to flip these buddies around and right here in pin 55 is the last one, and then 56 you actually have to run a wire from this side and you solder it onto the actual pin. Now this one's missing it, so you have to actually solder it in to right there. Otherwise you could use a TK ROM because it has the battery backup but it doesn't have the pin, and then you would have to add the battery. This right here is just your typical TL ROM, and it's just something you would make like a new Ghostbusters 2. You can pull these out of like Home Alone 2s and Tiny Toon Adventure 2s. So it's just basically different boards for different types of ROMs. So you just have to match, and it has to be compatible.
Right. You can't just take like a Mario 1 cart and turn that automatically into an Earthbound cart. It doesn't work that way. There are certain games that you have to pick up to make it, and that's why some reproduction carts get costly. For example, Mario 2s usually go for anywhere from, you know, $8 to $10 depending on where you buy them from. Deja Vu is kind of also a middle of the road, you know, NES game. Some reproduction carts are actually not worth making. Some require bigger sacrifices than the games you end up with.
That would be Just Breed. You would have to.
You have to
like
really want a Just Breed in order.
You have to use like a Gemfire, or I think it's like Uncharted Waters.
Yeah, games that are worth way more than Just Breed.
Right.
So, again, you can't just turn any game into any game. So, when you go to a swap mart, you're usually looking for, what, like, deals on these kind of games,
yeah.
Right?
You know, like, I try to find games like NES Open Golf, which is an SN ROM with a battery for a couple bucks. Because on eBay, it goes for about 10. 8 to 10. So you're looking for games like that to make a Final Fantasy II or a Sweet Home. Also, Shingen the Ruler. You can use a Legend of Zelda. It's the same kind of board, or
again,
a Metroid, but you really don't want to mess with those.
Yeah, it's one hell of a sacrifice to make a reproduction card.
Right. Popular games. Greg Norman's Power Golf is another one. Or Ultima, any of the Ultima games, if you can get them cheap enough.
So, yeah. Reproduction carts usually take a lot more than you might think. Anyhow, let's go to the swap meet and see what we can find.
Hello, dear viewer. This is Asalieri, and that, my friend, is Protitus. And we are looking through the flea market and see what we can find today.
We will find something. We're going to find something awesome.
Hey, there's those loterias.
Oh, yeah, he wants this game, South American game.
Yeah.
I don't know what it is, but it's his thing. He thinks it's cool.
So. Is there four?
Four?
Yeah.
Just take two?
Fine.
Why not?
Oh, he's gone.
Let me see. Four. I don't see him. He disappeared.
Oh, he's right behind you. I guess he le da dos por la lotería.
No?
No.
Okay.
They don't want our money. It's like we walked into a the Best Buy. The trick is, when you go to the swap meet, you think it's like a yard sale, but a little bit higher.
Yeah.
So everything should be like a couple bucks.
Yeah.
Let's see, we're getting this great service.
Yeah.
Tablet
of PSP stuff.
Yeah.
Ooh, PSP stuff. We're at the
Mostly
swap
movies.
Meet in Mesa, Arizona. I just sold a copy of that on eBay.
$14.
I got $5 for it.
You can get those. You get that. You can get that new online for $10.
I know. He saw Larry's looking at PSP stuff.
$25.
$15 for that.
You know I can download all this for you, right? I can mod your PISPA.
Dude, this is the game that's awesome. You haven't played.
As you see, Asa's using his sex appeal in for the ladies.
Never played that.
Yeah, me and Simon.
That looks interesting, actually.
It does look kind of cool.
It looks like something I'd play.
I have that on my PSP. That's a great game.
I didn't even check the price.
It's like an 8. It's 15 on 14. It's about 10 online.
It probably means they'll want 15 for that?
Yeah, 15. I think we should move on.
Yeah.
There's not going to be any flea market conquests here.
But, yeah.
Asa, tell us what you think about this swap meet so far.
So far, they want Best Buy prices for used shit.
It's ass!
At the risk of sounding like people like...
AVGN. He's an AVGN fan. He's in the closet, though.
Totally.
He stayed in there.
Every time I think of James Rolfe, I rub my nipples.
Say it again.
Oh, I think of... See, now I can't say it.
Outtakes. He says every time he thinks of James Rolfe, he rubs those. Twice. Man boobs.
Just Norteña music.
Yeah,
hello,
in California, they have these...
I didn't bring my shirt, but...
Do you want more money?
It's Pissed Jose here, and this is my favorite kind of music, Norteña. We can listen to Cuando Salgo a los Campos, or Puros Corridos, or my favorite, Los Plebeyos. The Peasants?
There's a band called
The Peasants, dude.
Everywhere I go, I play that.
I play this all the time, Missy. I knew at some point this Jose was going to come out. Find Obama 2012.
What? I think he made it. I think he won. Maybe. Tex-Mex music is Louise.
That's my song.
That's my song.
That's my song. I sing it all the time.
Cool, there's Batmobile.
Hey, bag of random bag of Legos.
You know, you can't go wrong with random Lego bags. Bag of Legos. Bart Simpson. Tools, Krusty the Clown. Vidya game stuff. Or is that Vidya? No, that's controllers. It's a police car.
Ain't no. They got some old random G.I. Joe parts. It's top secret, dude.
Well, you know.
Everything but the kitchen sink.
That's no, the bathroom
they
sink.
They brought the bathroom sink.
Close enough. Look, where's Mike Matei when you need him?
You know Mike Matei would have already done a masturbation joke.
I thought of it, but I refrained because it's Elmo.
And because Mike Matei already did it.
Yeah.
With in his, more ways than one.
And if you guys want to know, go watch RAR, the latest RAR, and you can find out what he's talking about. Okay.
Adventures at the swap meet.
You have any video games?
I don't think he's listening.
Video games?
No.
No? Okay.
Oh. This is the one that they were giving at, why do I know this? At McDonald's. I'm so happy. I'm so happy. I'm happy and gay. Care Bear looks so in love down there. He's like, buy me.
That was the good luck bear. That was the one I always thought was cool.
Good luck bear, please. Somebody buy me. Well, this one's definitely. Okay. Let's move.
All right. Thank
you. There's a couple of
I looked.
Oh, you looked?
I didn't see any, like, RPGs or stuff.
Or anything?
Yeah, I didn't see anything. It's, it goes in the regular CDs.
Yeah, but Shania Twain. I want it so bad.
You should get that for
Shania's
me.
Shania's awesome, man.
Yeah, we're filming a thing called Fat Guys Gone Wild. And staying that way.
I'm planning on showing my nipples at some point in the video. See, I knew somebody was going to have it cheaper, and these guys have it for $2.
Is it kind of weird for a guy to like those? You don't like them, right?
How weird is it for a grown man to like ponies? No?
Yeah, you'd rather play like with Batman, Faction Fear, Superman or something, or Wolverine.
Something manly.
That's what I played with when I was a kid.
Oh, but you got Pokemon!
What is this?
You got the Pokemon.
You gotta collect
box.
Them all, that's the rule.
It's an honor roll game!
You know, obviously nobody's reading this at this swap mart, or else, you know, we wouldn't be getting the people turning away us as customers.
I make a habit of doing this, I'm sorry.
Yeah, you should
idiot.
Do that.
I'm sorry. I'm a dumbass.
Cut! Hey, Jatos, do you want to buy Superhero?
Yes. Because Batman looks like he's going to take a dump and his thing's going to fall off.
Oh,
and it's got eyes. It's watching you. Hulk is Hulk's constipated.
Did you ever know that Batman and Iron Man were part of the same?
Yeah.
Marvel and DC together in one place. I love that, you know, like Iron Man, Spider-Man, Hulk, and
Iron Man has a very big cod piece. He's got
superhero. Or how about Extreme Super Samurai?
Yeah, it's like a Power Rangers rip, isn't it? Oh no, there's the Power Rangers down there.
Yeah, there's the Power Rangers rip down there.
Too bad this isn't a real gun, because if I own these, I'd shoot myself.
No, this is the best one. Forces of Justice!
Oh. I just got hit in the head with a little guitar.
With Forces of Justice? It gets here. There.
Jesus.
Hey, Jatos, you want the bat something? What is that?
Oh yeah, that's right.
Oh, you have a Batman tattoo, yeah.
I also have a Thundercats tattoo.
But that's not even a. What is that?
It's for little kids. It's a little kids set.
But look at the Batmobile. It's like the Fisher Price Batmobile.
Yeah. It goes with Fisher Price Batman.
Good grief. Boy, that was a labored joke, wasn't it?
How much?
And there's the freaking kitchen sink about early.
I knew we'd find it.
I knew we'd find everything and the kitchen sink.
Well, we came back from the swap meet, I say. And I even managed to pick up an official pissed Jose Berlard. He looks just like me. No, but for real,
this is the stuff that we picked up
At the swap meet today, we had quite an adventure, didn't we, today? I mean, look at all the stuff we picked up. And there's a story behind each and every one of these. Let me tell you, this guy here, this guy is a master haggler. Most of these things were stuff that were going for anywhere from $5 to $8, and for most of these, we paid a buck. Although the ones that I'm particularly proud of are these two, because I was the one that haggled the hell out of these.
With my Spanish skills, ese! Yeah, so they like wanted $5 for each of these. And I'm like, fuck you, man. I want them for like $6. And then they're like, no, $9. And then I was like, $7 or zero.
No, they ocho'd you for about an hour.
Oh, yeah, they wanted...
Because the guy was in the toilet.
Yeah, they wanted $8 for the longest time, and they were giving me the bullshit excuse that the guy was in the bathroom. Like, oh, no, my manager is in the bathroom, so we can't do deals for him. We'll give you a deal for $8 right now. Well, turns out the guy that was in the bathroom, quote-unquote, was just like, yeah, big quotes there. He just kind of appears from, behind the bush and says, yeah, I'll do it for $8, which was the same offer they were trying to give me. And then I'm like, look, it's either $7 or zero. So, naturally, he did the right thing and gave it for $7.
See, my thinking on it, the way I would have argued it in English is I would have said, so for a dollar, you're going to lose this sale.
Mm-hmm. So, that's the story behind those. The Grand Theft Auto is a little bit scratched, but at least it's got the instructions and everything.
Oh, and the...
This Monopoly board?
This has got the books, too.
Oh, yeah. And that's nice. That's not too shabby for a Genesis game.
Yeah, it's got...
Yeah.
Stickers nice.
This Monopoly board, which you picked up for a buck.
After you worked on
that lady. Of course, it's like a mess. They don't really care about putting these things together.
They weren't too hard. We
make sure that all the properties were there and everything.
Yeah, we went through it all.
Same thing with this clue. The guy started you off at $5, and we thought that there were cards missing. Turns out...
That's the board.
Yeah, it turns out there were cards like stuck inside the board. And after a couple of minutes, we talked that down to a buck, too.
Yeah, that's the first thing you looked when we looked at the Star Wars, too. You said, oh, yeah.
Yeah, are all the pieces there.
Yep, so we had everything's there.
Yep. Again, in a mess, but it's a swap meet. We can't expect much there. These two controllers, both SNES Turbo controllers.
He wanted two apiece. We got them both for three.
Both for three. Got a bunch of donor cards here. Well, pro wrestling, Gyromite with the creamy center. Maybe you can explain.
Okay, now what happened was in the...
What's special about Gyromite cards?
Well, the thing is, these you had a three screw or a five screw. Now, back in the mid 80s, you had certain carts, they were running low, mm-hmm. and they had to use Famicom adapters. So you put a Famicom board into an adapter with a 72 pin Nintendo board. Mm-hmm. And what you do, and they're heavier, and it's only the five screws, and it's always the black box games. So what you do is you open it up.
Most games have these three screw setups. And also, you'll notice that these have these little, clip-on things on the top.
Yeah, and these...
These older NES things I didn't know about. You might want to put them closer together there. Yeah.
Right, these do not.
Yeah, they don't have the little clasp thingies.
Because you screw them with the two top pieces.
Right.
Well, this one did not. It would have been... Wop, wop, wop. It would have had an adapter here, which would have been a black thing, and then it would have gone up, and it would have gone up into here.
And those are sweet to find in these, huh?
Yeah, they go on eBay for about $30.
So it's nice to pick one of these, useless, quote-unquote, games for a buck, and then finding one of those delicious things in the center, right?
Exactly.
Ultima Exodus, which you picked up two copies of for pretty cheap.
A couple bucks, yeah.
NES Open, that's another card that you're going to take down and put back together.
It's going to be a Sweet Home or a Final
Fantasy Mega Man X4. I wanted to take it, but he took it before I could. He found it before me. This GameCube. They wanted $20 for it. You talked them down to $10 on the basis that they... Yep. That there was no connection to the TV for it.
Right. We got everything else. Got controller and the plug. It's around here somewhere, but yeah. It's one of those nice fancy schmancy GameCubes.
We got these three pickups. Three games for $2.
which was quite the deal.
Yeah, we didn't even have to talk them down.
Yeah.
That was what they wanted.
And, yeah, those I'm keeping the armored core, and you want those.
Yeah.
This one was an interesting story. This guy started off at $5.
Oh.
And he didn't, he's like this guy who's like, yeah.
Also.
I don't know what he is.
This is the first one. See, Asa didn't know about my bargaining skills.
Yeah, this is the one where I first found out what your prowess with,
Right.
With this was.
And I basically kept talking to the guy and saying, you know, I finally say to him, how many other people have asked about this?
And he's like, oh, good point.
Okay, a dollar. That's what he said. Okay, a dollar.
Okay, a dollar. Now, really nice is I got this a really decent copy of Jade Empire. It's in pretty good condition for a dollar. And wow. I didn't even need your help for that one.
No, I just wanted to
yoinked it, you know?
Yeah, sometimes they just...
Now, these are the NES cartridges that I picked up for myself. Quite cheap. $2 to $4 for most of these. But these are all games that I enjoy. This is a game we're going to play a lot in a moment. Rest now, my friend. Defender of the Crown.
It's not whether you can get anywhere, it's how far
you can. Yep. I grew up with this game. I'm probably the only person who loves it. And just like him, I also had to get my own copy of that. This was strictly for the wife, who is a complete Zelda fanatic. Yeah, and those were our pickups for today. Pretty nice swag for one visit. And, yeah. And here's my new NES. Thanks to you. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. It's based on my Sweet Home car, if any of you guys have seen that on my channel.
Yeah, if you guys want, you know, custom paint jobs on your NESs or NESs fixed up, this is the man to go to. YouTube, Protitus.
Well, there's nothing more to talk about, so till next time, dear viewer.